Aber die beiden Schweizerinnen, Olivia Wüst und Eliane Waser, sind sicher auf dem zweiten Platz. Sie rudern hier wirklich ein fantastisches Rennen. Jetzt mit 2 Bootslängen Vorsprung vor den aufkommenden Argentinierinnen, die die Brasilianerinnen überholt haben. Und Korea in Position 5 vor Japan auf 6. Die Schweiz weiterhin auf Platz 2, noch 200 Meter zu rudern.
Australia is still in the lead and we look at their dominant performance here with much respect. It's Switzerland, a spirited performance from them as well after failing to qualify. They had some, of course, they had to pick up their psyche there, and now they come together again for Munich and perform well here at the Munich World Rowing Cup. Second place for them at the B final, no doubt about the leaders. It's Australia leading the way home ahead of Switzerland, and what a good performance, spirited final sprint here on the last 500 for Argentina. Maria Clara Rona and Mirka Kraljev pick it up and will finish in third place.
Germany and Australia having a pretty successful morning here, and Australia getting the vocal support from the grandstand. See one or two Australian flags already out in force, some German flags too, the Italian flags, some British flags, so lots of support in the grandstand for these B finalists. And it was Australia coming through, Watson and Every Hall, to take seventh place in the lightweight women's double scull, 7:42.56. Switzerland in second, 7:48.78. And Argentina third, 7:52.48.
Die beiden Australierinnen hatten das Rennen hier von Anfang an dominiert und konnten ihren Vorsprung, den sie früh rausgearbeitet haben, bis über die Ziellinie retten. Und mit einer Zeit von 7 Minuten und 42 Sekunden holen Bronwyn Watson und Hannah Everyhall somit einen weiteren Weltcup-Punkt für Australien.
On we go then with the B final of the lightweight men's double sculls. This is the lineup. 6 crews in action. From the inside, it's Egypt. Next to them, the crew from Poland. Brun and Strandli are Norway in 3. Fraga and Mendes of Portugal in 4. Mexico in 5. And Argentina are in lane 6. So race 142 on the program. This is the B final then of the lightweight men's double sculls, and once again we can join our commentary team of Paul and Franz.
We are here and we are seeing a 3-belt lead here in this particular event. We see here the crews from Norway doing a very good job leading Portugal, and then behind Egypt, and then we have the 3 belts a bit further back. So that's Norway. So that's Strandli and Brun, they are currently in the lead here in the B final. Great crew there, and of course we have seen this before. Norway are still mixing up their squad. They have 3 quality scholars trying to determine the fastest combination for the London Olympics, and it looks as though Strandli and Brun may have, well, what it takes to race in a double at the Olympic level. Fraga and Mendes, they have been there before, the Portuguese double. They have been finding the competition a bit too much for the last 2 seasons, having trouble making the finals in hotly contested events. But still, they are a quality crew and they might just be able to take this one. Now putting ahead, pushing up on Norway just a bit. And then Egypt also, it's still in third position, still almost in contact. This one far from over, as we are now through the 1000 meters.
Ja, es geht Schlag auf Schlag weiter im Programm heute, und die Starterin Zvara Ganejeva, sie bringt jetzt ein Rennen nach dem anderen gut auf den Weg, alle brav und pünktlich am Start heute im Gegensatz zu den 2 vorhergehenden Tagen. Und ein gewisses Déjà-vu hier jetzt auf dem Wasser, dann im B-Finale in Luzern im Samsung-Ruder-Weltcup vor ein paar Wochen die Norweger als Erste ins Ziel im B-Finale. Und jetzt führt eine etwas andere Kombination aus Norwegen ebenfalls das Feld im B-Finale an. 1250 Meter sind jetzt gerudert, und die einzigen, die wirklich mit den Norwegern mitgehen können, das ist Portugal. Und der Schlagmann Nuno Mendes hat gerade nach rechts geschaut zu dem Heck von den Norwegen, um zu schauen, kann er vielleicht jetzt diesmal einen Punkt für Portugal gewinnen? Denn Norwegen hat schon 3 Punkte in diesem Klassement. Alle anderen Boote im Moment weit abgeschlagen.
And as we're looking at the Portuguese double of Nuno Mendes and Pedro Fraga, interesting to see the different lengths of these persons, and not their strokes, but they're virtually level. But then again, we see the bowman is about a head taller than the stroke man. We have seen this before in doubles. For instance, Denmark with Mats Rasmussen and Rasmus Quist just goes to show that you don't need like physical clones to have a good racing double, and this is also what Portugal is demonstrating here. Still in the lead, Norway about a length up on Portugal, and then at the back of the field, Egypt has now faded, and Poland is coming through. And Poland, of course, crew to watch. They are young. They have just gone out of under 23s, and well, I am working on grammar and syntax, and I've now also added pronunciation to my workshop of mastering the English language. And I have been told that it's not the heir to the throne, but the heir to the throne. And these are, of course, what the Polish are, because the great Polish double of Robert Cicz and Tomasz Kucharski, the champions of 2000 and 2004, their position at the top is still vacant. And these two young rowers from Poland, Artur Mikołajczyk and Miloš Jankowski, they'll be looking to take that position. But the position in the B final, that goes to Norway, now heading into the final 250 meters, still clearly in the lead.
Ja, Castlepedia tut, was es kann, Franz, für dich, und hilft dir weiter. 250 Meter bis zur Ziellinie. Und die Norweger, ja, auch das hat Bums, wie in dem Rennen vorher im deutschen Boot, das ich kommentieren durfte. Die sind jetzt wirklich von Beginn an losgefahren und Portugal jetzt in der Schlussphase ebenfalls abgehängt.
This is going to be Norway to the finish. And also keep an eye out on the other Norwegian double, the open weight double that we'll see racing later this day in the Olympic final of the men's double sculls. They did a very good job at the semi-final yesterday, and we're anxious to see what they will be doing in the finals today, as we now move toward past the tents where the tables have been set for a delightful lunch later on this day. We now see the B final of the lightweight men's double sculls, and Norway dealing a blow to Portugal. Norway taking a clear first, Portugal will be second, and then the young crew from Poland will have to sprint it out with the crew from Mexico to take third, and that's how it's going to end the B final of the lightweight men's double sculls.
Super performance by Norway, Christopher Bruun and Ari Strandli out there in lane 3. 6:52.07 was the time for the winners. They pick up 7th place, and that is worth a point in the World Rowing Cup standings. So Norway coming home in 1st place, Portugal in 2nd, 6:55.35, and Poland 3rd, 6:59.55.
Eine fantastische Leistung gezeigt haben hier die Ruderer aus Norwegen, die mit einer Zeit von 6 Minuten und 52 Sekunden auf den ersten Platz in diesem B-Finale des Leichtgewichts Doppelzweier der Männer fahren und somit einen weiteren Weltcup-Punkt holen. Nur 3 Sekunden dahinter kam Portugal übers Ziel und mit einem Rückstand von 7,5 Sekunden auf dem 3. Platz und somit auf dem 9. Platz im Gesamtklassement das Boot aus Polen.
We move on to the B final of the